This is Dr. Catherine Bankole Medina, and continuing with our history and historiography series, we will focus on an overview of the historical process. As we begin, recall that we are constantly engaging the question, what is history? There are many responses to the question, but all contain the essential idea that history is the study of the past. Most scholars will generally tell you that history is a narrative or a formal story of events, that it is a chronological record of the past, which explores the life and the development of people and institutions, civilizations. Historians not only tell a story through themes and dates, they explain or comment on the past. As a formal discipline, history is not just the examination of records and the analysis of past events. History is the foundation for all knowledge. We also recognize that history is a mediated public discourse, meaning that it is subject to a social and political context and dependent upon cultural perceptions. In explaining the historical method, Dr. Paul D. Leedy stated that, quote, "History is a phenomenon. It is a transcript of the relentless surge of events, the sequential and the meaningful record of human activity," unquote. According to Dr. Seshwani T. Kato, history, quote, "separates the first fundamental reality of a people's existence, namely the past, from the second fundamental reality of their existence, namely the present," unquote. It also possesses, according to Kato, a third element which completes the triad, namely the future. But the future exists by definition only in a people's vision and in their plans, which only become actualized in the present. History, then, given its continual unfolding within the context of the present and the future, is considered one of the highest forms of critical thinking in the humanities and social sciences, largely because it requires concerted and intense scrutiny of the past. History is a dialogue with and an interpretation of the past. History involves a dynamic relationship with knowledge and information. Because everything must address the idea of history in some way, history is an integrative discipline. It involves the acquisition of functioning knowledge of multiple fields. For example, the study of the enslavement of Africans in North America is not possible without a command of United States and world histories. In terms of the historical process, historians and students of history engage in rigorous analytical thinking. For our brief purposes here, this involves a five-stage process that encompasses research, organization, analysis, interpretation, and communication. In the area of research, historians rely upon their ability to locate primary and secondary sources. These documents provide the facts and evidence necessary to reconstruct the past. Once a set of materials have been located, the historian reads, makes notes, uncovers other data, and begins the process of organizing information. And once the material has been read and questioned and clearly understood, analysis then takes place. Analysis also includes the evaluation of sources. Students of history learn how to discern reliable sources from primary and secondary source materials. We move forward to interpret the materials collected and the analysis performed. The main goal is to be able to explain the meaning of the sources, draw reasonable conclusions, tell a story, and allow the audience to also draw their own conclusions. Remember that historians do not tell people what actually happened in the past. They relate the events of the past based upon the evidence that they have collected and evaluated. Once interpretation has been conducted, the student of history considers how they will communicate their findings. Historical insights and ideas are shared in writing, in a print and/or digital format, through the production of books, articles, etc., or verbally, through lectures and conference presentations, in an effort to inform and to stimulate discussion. Remember, we currently live within the constructs erected by the past, and we all recede into history with every passing moment.